The main reason I got started is because I love God's Word and I want to be in it in a smaller setting, and that we can share and pray together and study the Word together. And you said in your opening about if you're new to the congregation, you don't know people. I've been here my whole life, but I am disassociated with it. I don't have kids in school. I'm widowed. And so the few people I sit around is who I see and know from the past. And many that I know are in the cemetery right now. Unfortunately, they're in heaven. Mm-hmm. But I joined to meet people also because I didn't know anyone. So when I walked into the room, I knew the host and hostess, and I knew the 12 other people or 14. I never had seen them in my life. And they all went to St. Paul's for 5, 10, 14, 15 years. Right. But they didn't go to my service. So right. I didn't know any of them. It took me months to get to know their first name.
Yeah.
And we met weekly, and we were in God's Word, which I loved, and we kept to a time frame, and we didn't, they knew each other, a few knew each other, but we were all strangers coming because we loved Jesus. And that was why I got into it. The verse that comes to mind, seek you first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you. And if people think, oh, this is another night of the week, it is, yes, it's a maybe an hour or two, but if you're seeking God's kingdom first, those other things fall in better than you ever can imagine. And it's around God's Word and prayer. I can't tell you how prayer has been a huge part in our group, the more we got to know each other. And truly, if anyone in this congregation, you all have big things. And you don't share them after church with somebody.
Right.
But here, you found out, oh, they have similar things. Oh, this one's a widow. This one has a child that doesn't really like coming to church or doesn't like God. And you pray for each other. And we really did. We held up each other in prayer during the week and especially together. And it wasn't just one doing it. And you got more comfortable.
In your experiences, speak to some of the skills that people learn by being in this smaller group.
Some had never, ever read scripture out loud in front of anyone, or maybe even opened their Bible, is what I got the feeling. Some of us were very much more comfortable doing that. And you learn from one another. And then everybody read, and if, you know, the words that are this long.
Or the names.
I skip them, because we all see it, that we're all going to, you know, massacre it. So anyway, and somebody will say it, and then we move on, and you could see the growth in the being more comfortable, or even if they didn't pray out loud. Or just short, because we'd go around the group and end with praying around, and you could pass. But it was, and the simplest prayers are the most touching prayers. They don't have to be eloquent and pastoral.
Right, right.
You know.
Yeah. What am I missing by not being involved in a small group?
Everything.
That's a lot to say. What do you mean by that?
Seek ye first the kingdom of God. If I would live on one steak dinner in an hour on a Sunday and expect that to get me through on Friday night and Monday mornings, you're robbing God. It's a command. He wants us to be in his word. And that's why I've always thought small groups are important, or a Bible study, to be in his word and to be fed. And that some of us in the small group would do this, daily then.
Yeah.
And be in that chapter of Matthew or whatever we're studying. And it would lead to a psalm, or someone would say, oh, I'm reading Psalm 39 or 139. And then you'd go home and go, oh, I've never read that one before. And then it speaks to you. We as Christians, and especially in this day and age, but all Christians, you need to be in the Word. Another benefit, we encourage one another. We could even, you know, we called or emailed each other. So just, there was one other widow in the group, and I was able to encourage her on the side and whatever. And then later, after you get to know these people, they become your friends, and we stayed together, I think 7 years. Some left and some new ones came in. And then, unfortunately, you know, 18 months ago or so, one that I really love, this couple, her husband died unexpectedly, which just took our group, you know, it was very, we all lost a friend.
Yeah.
But that is who God had said, someday after you've been a widow, you come alongside. And that's, I never knew her. She lived in Franklin all my years of me living in Muskego. Never, ever saw her. The kids went to Wisconsin Lutheran but after my kids. So now we're best friends.
Yeah.
But I would have never, I've gone through the whole life without meeting these people. So that, to be able, and that people stand alongside me, it is a congregation within the big congregation.
From your perspective, what's the benefit of a small group for, again, that person who's in this, the single and in their 20s, or married but with little kids? What's the value?
For the single young person, it gives you a family. And there are so many people coming from not intact families. And this would be their first place that they ever were in a small Christian environment. And you can share. And the first time they maybe ever heard anyone pray out loud in a small group. And it's, you catch on, and the power of the Word works. And it gives you a family and the right basis, because the whole world is telling you opposite of what God's Word is telling you in this day and age. It's never been more clear and more black and white.
Yeah.
And then to a family, oh, I wish they had this back then, if there's babysitting.
And there is, and we offer the ability to help cover babysitting.
Well, that's perfect, yep. Because if ever people needed to get away from your children, it's when the kids are little, and I'm talking seventh grade on down, and when they're toddler age, I've heard a Christian author say it's the hardest thing to be a parent of toddlers and a mother of toddlers. And it is wonderful. You just need time away from your children, and then to be with people that maybe there's many that are in your same boat, and you can say, yes, that is so true. I'm in another group with mainly grandmas. We're all grandmas. But boy, is it good to be reinforced with grandmas than going, oh, yeah. So, yeah, parents, and you're raising children. What you do now, you're setting the foundation for your children. And if you're not growing, they aren't going to grow.
Oh, yeah, great. I think, yeah, with everything else that's going on, I think that we'll end it here, because I can start to hear creeping and crawling. They're the little ones. But Karen, thank you so much for your time today and your words. And God's blessings in the ministry that you provide to other people.
Thank you, and the same to you. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you, God.
You did it, and he gave you words to say.
He
good
did.
Words to say.